sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
A ghost is an alleged non-corporeal manifestation of a dead person, or, rarely, an animal or a vehicle. It is often thought to be a manifestation of the spirit or soul of a person which has remained on earth after death. According to some beliefs, a ghost may be the personality of a person after his or her death, and not directly tied to the soul or spirit. Every culture in the world carries stories about ghosts, though they often disagree as to what ghosts are and whether they are just figments of imagination or a part of reality. Multidimensional entities have always been part of our experience in third dimension. Ghost sightings have been reported in most parts of the planet, with some reports being written, photos, drawings, folk tales, even carved on stone, hieroglyphs in caves. Ghosts are often depicted of a human size and shape, although some accounts also mention animal ghosts, but typically described as silvery, shadowy, semi-transparent, misty, human-like, big, scary, or fog-like. Parapsychologists refer to the substance of which ghosts and other spirits are made of as ectoplasm. Ghosts do not have a physical body like human beings, but only a subtle astral body. Sometimes they do not manifest themselves visually but in terms of other phenomena, such as the movements of an object, spontaneous throwing of a light switch, noises, etc., which supposedly have no natural explanation. Some ghost researchers approach the possibility of ghosts from a more scientific standpoint, seeking to find correlations and causal relationships between recordable phenomena and the supposed presence of ghosts. Those who follow this approach most often believe that ghosts are not actual disembodied souls or spirits, but rather they are impressions of psychic energy left behind by a deceased, or in some rare cases, still living, person. They assert that traumatic events, such as a murder or suicide, cause mental energy to be released into the world, where it may be experienced by other people who are sensitive to its presence. This way of thinking classifies ghosts in the same category of preternatural unexplained phenomena as poltergeists, telekinesis, ESP, and telepathy. Theories from this approach often encounter difficulties in explaining ghosts that appear to be sentient, such as those which answer questions or react to specific actions from people present. However, it may be possible that enough of a dead person's psyche might be imprinted on an environment so as to give the likeness of thought or autonomy.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.